Hey, it's Luke with Out of Darts. Today I'm going to give you my overview and thoughts on the Hyper ammo type. This ammo is very, very interesting, and I have been waiting for this for quite some time, and it's pretty exciting, to be honest. Obviously, when Rival came out, I was really into the Rival ammo. The Rival ammo has been around for a few years now. It's proven to be very reliable, durable, and extremely, extremely popular. So naturally, when a new ammo type came out that was similar but smaller, I really wanted to dive in and get going. Now, we've already got reviews on all three of these blasters, including the Rush 40, the Siege 50, and the Mach 100. We're also releasing a mod guide for the Mach 100, and we'll have mod guides for the other blasters as well, just for those of you that want to see the nitty-gritty of inside and how to open them up and replace the spring and any tips and tricks we figure out. We have modded all three of these blasters already. These both have K25s in them, while this has a 3S LiPo and a complete rewire. It's worth noting, if you want the shortcut, the 3S on this blaster is probably not going to last long term. The motors sound pretty sick, so mod at your own risk. We'll talk more about that in the mod guide for that specific blaster. First, let's talk about the ammo itself and its physical characteristics. This is a traditional Rival round, and here is our Hyper round. Obviously, it's noticeably smaller, and they're a completely different material. This is much more of a foam. It's very soft, very compressible, and not all that bouncy. This is a TPE, some sort of thermoplastic, and it is very extremely squishy, very dense, and much denser, has a higher sectional density than this ammo does. This ammo is heavier, the Rival ammo is heavier overall, but it is obviously a much larger round. Comparing the size of the two, the standard Rival rounds are around 21.5, has usually been my measurement over the years, and the new Hyper rounds come in at about 13.9, I thought, 14. Let's see here what we get. A little hard because we're kind of squeezing this until we drop it through. I guess we're getting about 14.5. The density of this ammo was one of the most important characteristics for me when I first heard about it. And so the first thing I did when I got the ammo was compare it to regular Rival. It's a good idea when anytime you're gonna try weigh something to do it in bulk and then do the math. So I've got 10 regular Rival rounds here. I'm gonna throw on my reasonably accurate scale, and we're getting about 1.865 grams per round. Now, if I take those off and we take a look at 10 Hyper rounds, you'll see we're getting about 1.38 grams. And that's pretty impressive because the size disparity in these two rounds is relatively large, meaning that this is extremely dense in comparison. The relative surface area of these new Hyper rounds is much lower, along with the relative density being higher. Does mean that these will hit target faster and really perform quite a bit better, assuming they're shot out of a similar system that can actually propel them far enough. What I've seen over the years with Rival blasters is that Rival ammo will only fire so far. It does not matter how hard you fire these out of a blaster, even at 200 feet per second, the gains on distance for a Rival ammo is relatively low compared to, say, 130 FPS. In our testing, the difference in range between a 130 FPS Nemesis blaster and a brushless cage that also has a hop-up shooting at 200 FPS was only about 20 to 25 feet. That may sound like a lot, but that performance difference is a lot of work to get to. It's also a lot harder on the ammo, and overall, it really just kind of, there's a ceiling for these ammos. So as far as I'm concerned, about 100 FPS is as good as you're going to get with these blasters, because the difference between 150 and 200 was less than 20 feet, more like 15 to 18 feet from my recollection. While the ammo in theory can perform a lot better, and in some cases definitely is hitting target faster, I have not found the accuracy to be better, and that goes across the entire line. So far in my tests, the Rush 40 has actually been the most accurate, and that is rather odd considering this one does not have a hop-up. The Siege 50 does have a hop-up, but doesn't seem to be any more accurate than the Rush 40, and the Hyper Mach 100 has no hop-up and is the least accurate of the entire lineup so far. It's worth noting that my flywheels in the Hyper Mach 100 do seem to be a little off-center. So when a ball is in the middle here, they kind of look a little bit just slightly off by a millimeter and a half, maybe 2 millimeters. That could be part of the problem, but ultimately, this is the blaster that Hasbro's PR team chose to send to me. I'm going to review it as I've received it. And I don't think anybody else has said that this is a real accurate blaster. Overall, the initial offering is not performing substantially higher than Rival, so I don't see the reason to switch for that. However, there are some major benefits in the system. The largest advantage by far is the sheer size of these rounds. I made a Perseus Hopper that holds 160 rounds, and it is fairly massive compared to what it would take to hold 160. In my hands here are just 10 rounds each of Rival and Hyper, and the comparison is fairly stark. You're going to get a lot more onboard storage capacity with Hyper, and the Rush 40 is a perfect example of that. If this is allowed in an HVZ game, it is going to be one of the best HVZ sidearms or even primary blasters that's ever been made. Having 40 rounds in a Chronos style blaster is incredible. I've lasted ages in a game just using a Chronos and reloading on the fly, but being able to fire 40 rounds is pretty amazing. Next, I want to talk about durability, because with the Rival series, that was a huge plus. Compared to darts, Rival ammo lasts for a long, long time. This is a piece of ammo that looks like garbage, but it is literally from the original Zeus I ever bought. It is from the first Rival blaster that ever hit the market, and it still fires. You can notice, hopefully, in this video that it has been worn away. There are parts of it missing. There's even a little flap cut here. But this will fire out of every Rival blaster that's out there. You can go one step farther, and even ones with cuts out of them, these likely got cut by flywheels or pinched or something like that as they came out, even this one will still fire out of most blasters. Now, it's going to have lost some accuracy because it's starting to look more like a square or a cube, but durability was a pretty good bonus of these balls compared to regular darts, because you can step on them, you can run them over with a car, you can get them wet and they still function. Hyper has taken this one step further. Anybody who's modded a 3S blaster or has shot something like my Proton Pack or a Jupiter knows that Rival balls tend to emit dust. And that's what you can see in this round here, is where lots of little tiny bits of foam have been cut off of the ball or shaved off of the ball, and that over time will wear down the ball. In my tests so far, the Hyper rounds are considerably more durable. They are not only more durable to cuts and abrasion, but there's no dust coming out of these blasters whatsoever, even out of the Mach 100 with the flywheels modded. And I think that's a good step in the right direction. I think with the density and durability of this TPE material, these are really going to last a long time, assuming you can find them. Also, I saw American Foam over on YouTube had a social post about these being UV reactive. And that's something I'm going to test out as well, because that should make them a lot easier to find if you had a nice UV flashlight at night. They're obviously very bright. I think the blasters themselves will also react really well inside. So these would be really, really cool in an indoor arena, like a laser tag arena with UV lights, because you'd basically get to see them flying like they're glowing, and they'd be a lot easier to find. So that could be fun for indoor wars as well. Next thing I want to do is actually cut a couple of these open. So I've got an X-Acto knife here, and we're going to cut open and kind of rip these open. Oh my gosh, you are so squishy. I mean, just seeing how much this resists a knife cut is really shows, you know, does speak to durability. So one of the things we all often saw with the off-brand Rival ammo, now keep in mind this is genuine Hasbro, this is pretty consistent all the way through, but a lot of the off-brand stuff will definitely have more inconsistencies inside, like air gaps. Now, we are looking into making ammo, so that much should be obvious, but you'll see that inside this thing, it is just completely solid, and that's just the way injection molds work, since this is a complete 100% filled-in round. It's not going to have any air gaps, very unlikely to have any air gaps, and because of that, we're going to get more consistent weights and more consistent hopefully performance. On the note of durability, one other thing I have noticed with these is that they get kind of gross. This is just shot around my warehouse and picked up a couple times, and they're already pretty grimy. Now, it's not to say that Rival doesn't get there as well. This is a 5 or 6 year old round, as old as they can possibly be. It's got a marking here. There used to be Sharpie there that was from the very first batch I ever bought, and I never marked them again like that after, so I know that this is a very old round. But I do think these are gonna be pretty grimy. However, I think with the material, I'm gonna look up the material sheet for TPE. Now, there are a whole bunch of different TPEs and TPUs, so it could be that it's not compatible, but I suspect you could put these in a dishwasher or a clothing washer in a bag, but try that at your own risk. If you're interested in seeing whether we can clean them, comment down below and maybe I'll give that a try as a short or TikTok video in the future. Overall, at the end of the day, I think this is a really good step for Hasbro. It's a better ammo type potentially. It's got some down, it has some pitfalls and it is not perfect, but I am much more excited about this than I am the Elite 2.0 and the disastrous Nerf Ultra lineup. So I'd love to hear what you think in the comments. What would you like to see next from the Hyper line? We're gonna do mod guides for all of the blasters. And we've got a few other things we're gonna try out. Obviously, I still wanna make a proton pack for this blaster, though with the stickiness, it's proving to be a little bit more difficult than expected. It's not as clean cut as I had hoped. There's also been comments about putting something like talcum powder or baby powder or flour or cornstarch. Do that at your own risk. It might make them less sticky and maybe they would feed better, but you're gonna end up with that garbage all over your blaster. That's it for now. Thank you again for watching. Do hit that like button on the way out. Until next time, I'm out of darts.